I play Katie Frank. She's an elementary school teacher. She's also a single mother, and her son happens to be in her class. And she is also in a custody battle with the parents, or his grandparents, so the father's parents. And they go to the hospital to kind of sing for some sick people, and they end up stuck in the hospital. So she has to be the protector, keep the parents calm, and make sure that all the kids are safe and kept under control. So I really loved the character. She's very complex. She's strong. She's vulnerable. She's got a story, which is so beautiful to get to tell. So that attracted me to the project, just like well-written women, you know, like strong women who are broken and have stories and represent women. So I'm very excited to play a role like that. The project itself is great. You know, when I read scripts, if I want to know what's going to happen in the next episode, I tell that. That tells me it's going to be a good project. So immediately when I read the script, I was like, okay, what's happening next? So, but yeah, and great people on board. So I just feel so blessed to be a part of it. It's great because it's real. You know, there's a lot of viral series. You turn into a zombie, something supernatural. But what's great about this is it's real. Like, it has happened. And you have a degree of separation when you see the stuff in the news, right? You hear about Ebola and you kind of know, okay, it trickled here, but you don't really get to know the actual victims. So what's great about this is you get to know these people and you get to fall in love with them and see them go through these kind of chaotic times and see how they deal with it. And, you know, people under crisis can be very... They can be very animalistic, or they can be very, very heroic. So I just love that.
Are we going to pretty quickly have to deal with a birth in the containment zone?
Oh, because there's a baby coming. I don't know how many months along she is. She looks like she's going to pop.
Yeah, it looks pretty
far. She looks like she's like at 7 or 8.
I mean, they were meeting with adoption agents. So.
Oh, that means to talk to the baby. Now, I think maybe adoptions would go on hold at this point. Because there's like, you know,
right,
more important
but
things.
That's how far along she is that they were ready to...
Right. I think, yeah, there could be a baby. It'd be like The Walking Dead, right? A new baby coming in at a crazy time. But, yeah, maybe. It'd be cool to see if it's a boy or a girl and what it's like growing up kind of around the virus. I really hope the baby doesn't get sick. That would really suck.
I mean, is there also an aspect that if characters are meeting who never would have met in another situation, they might have a very positive relationship, that good things can come out of this very tragic situation? But...
Yeah, I think any situation is like that. There's always kind of a beautiful silver lining in anything. I think that's what Jake and Katie are, why they're so great. You wouldn't necessarily think that Jake and Katie would come together in the outside world. They seem to kind of butt heads a little bit at first. So for them to find a close relationship, whatever, I don't know exactly what's going to happen. But it's beautiful to see relationships build and also see relationships that started before this crisis and see how they can handle the pressure. So with that, yeah, it's really cool. Definitely, I do. I love Katie. I think I have the kind of survivor instinct that she has. I love kids. I actually, which is funny, David Nutter, our director, sent me one of the songs the kids sing in the actual hospital, and I mentor kids and I teach them how to sing, and we go to seniors' homes, and so I do that in my regular life. So it's really beautiful to see life mimic art. And Katie's, yeah, she's strong, but she's broken and vulnerable, and all women have a story to tell and a broken heart, and I think that's a lot like me. But she's also different in a lot of ways too, so I get to kind of explore that. You have to bring who you are to every character. So essentially, she is me, just in this situation.
Yeah, they have a lot of preparation for the role.
Definitely. I try and eat, sleep, and breathe it, you know? I'm always trying to think through her mind and think about what would Katie do. And in life, kind of, if a situation arises where I can learn something about who she is, then I take that. Like, I interviewed a few friends who are single moms and who've been through abusive relationships, so I could understand their world. And then I found what related in my life, if there was anything, even if it's not the same thing, you know, a little inkling of what that was, and use that. So yeah, always prepping, always thinking about her, always finding a new thing to learn.
How many episodes have you read so far?
Just the pilot.
Okay, yeah. So you... And how far ahead have you read?
I don't know anything.
Nothing.
That's a good line.
I know, it could be lying. I don't know. But no, it's really exciting. Actually, we were on the train on the way here, and Matt and Chris were sitting, our showrunners were sitting with what looked like a script, and I was like, what is that over there? And I'm like, oh, I see Atlanta. What is that? Let me read it. And they were like, top secret. So, I don't know. I'm so excited to get the first script and just get to learn how all of these characters unfold, because I think these are some of the best written relationships and characters I've ever read in a script. And there's such a heartbeat and a stunning undercurrent of love in this project, so I'm just so excited to see how people grow and change. Yeah.
Have you met?
We start mid-August, early mid-August. So we're all packing up our bags and getting ready to move to Atlanta, finding apartments and all that.
Have you met the rat named Justin Bieber yet?
I've met all the rats. Actually, that day on set, I kept playing with them and getting distracted, and they kind of climb over the little crates, and I was like, go, be free, it's okay, I won't tell them. But they were really cute, they were really cute.
Are they all named after a different pop star?
There's Rolf, Justin Bieber, I can't remember all of them. I'm sure we could start naming them.
That's cool you're not freaked out by rats.
No, I like creepy crawly things. I used to like play with worms when I was a kid, and I used to have pet nukes. Their names were Bert and Ernie. They were black and they had like orange tummies. So yeah, I like all that stuff.
You want to start shouldn't freak you out at all?
Oh yeah, well, bloody coughing up blood is a little bit of a different world. Yes, I'm a slight hypochondriac. Slight. So I think everybody will become one once you watch the show.